Hey there, signs of Gemini. This is Kim here to do your reading for you for the total solar eclipse. Can't believe I just said that. Lunar eclipse. Total lunar eclipse. The full blood moon coming up on the 26th. This is going to be a time about releasing blocks, things that have kept you stuck, possibly. Uncovering, you know, it is the shadow passing in front of the moon. So we have the shadow side probably revealing things. What else do we have? We have big endings. And usually it's associated, since it's the moon, with emotional endings. So like an emotional cycle that has ended and the start of a new one. Anything that you've been trying to hide or unconsciously have driving you will be like exposed. All right. So, spirit guides, angels, what do we got? We got stars in the sky as limitless possibilities, Gemini. That's your first card. Limitless possibilities, stars in the sky. Then we have, you have the lay of the land. It's like you're conquering whatever that moon has to offer. The stars in the sky with the limitless possibility says to aim for all of your hopes and desires, because you'll probably get most of them anyway. Lay of the land, I feel this is talking about your spiritual gifts. Because it says ancestral wisdom here, and I think that the land is like a metaphor for whatever spiritual gift was passed down to you. That's what I'm feeling. It's like that you have some kind of control or ability, special gift, because of something that runs in the family line. And it gives you an advantage. Like, it gives you an advantage, a lay of the land. Willow the Wisp. Treasures hidden in the shadows. So your eclipse is gonna bring you treasures because it's hiding in the shadows. That's exactly what's passing over the moon. So you truly have gems inside of something that was particularly hard for you to go through. Something that might have been, well, it still might be going through, but there's a treasure there. There's something wonderful in it. Okay, next one. Well, isn't that weird? That is so weird looking. That monkey. Dream thief, refusal of the call. Refusal of the call. Let's get one more, just because I'm just curious. After that, what would come after that? Horseman, herald of change. So, bringing in some change. This is bringing in some change. Let's look up, let me look up your cards first for you and give you a little bit more detailed information. So, stars in the sky is what number? 51. Okay, this is about embracing opportunity when it's in front of you. Gathering your thoughts and all your cherished dreams. So it's like gathering more than one just dream, you know? And then take small steps towards calling this glittery potential into reality. It says the universe does have its own ideas on how best to serve you, so trust in this. Okay, lay of the land. I told you what I believe that card is about. And the Willow the Wisp is this inspiration. It's an inspirational thing. It's either an object, situation, or person from coming from a place of either Three of Swords energy or some kind of darkness, maybe shadow work, maybe dark night of the soul energy. So 13, dream thief. I've never heard of this card before. Rejection of the path of fulfillment. Uh-oh. Refusal of the call. The dream thief is a soft and compelling seductress. Her only purpose is to keep you hypnotized by comfort and sameness. She wants you to tell your old stories over and over so that you don't evolve past them. This is strange. Okay. Ask yourself whether you are reverting back to the familiarity of your origin story. Teaching from an old wound will never bring you a new adventure. Okay, so your ancestors might be saying, hey, look, we've always done things this way. We want you to do something different. That's, I mean, I'm like looking at this literally. It says, you are so much more than you know. Of course you are. Now it's time to express what has lain dormant. So what is lain dormant? These spiritual gifts you have inside, passed down from, you know, generations of ancestral wisdom. Number 30 is horseman or horseman. Okay, this means good news coming in and a herald of change. Good. When this card appears, the horseman is inviting you to spread the good news. Says everybody already knows the bad news. So your task is to point out the silver lining and the beautiful things that you see. Be a herald of the positive. That's sweet. It says, heed the horseman when he shows up, for he bears good news and is announcing a prosperous and peaceful time. When he shows up twice in a reading, though, use caution. Okay, so yay, this is good news coming in, too. So the eclipse might be bringing some really great things for you. And that would be really good. That would be really good. Really nice. Because a lot of people are getting huge change in the form of tower moments that's having to rearrange things that maybe we should have fixed or took care of, but put off. So the universe, like it says, has its own way of doing things that best serve you. Okay. All right, Gemini, we're just going to shuffle these and then I'm going to split them and we're going to pull them off the deck. General Celtic crossbred for Gemini. One more little shake. Okay. Whoop. The underlying issue, Three of Wands, being in receiving mode, expecting to receive. You can see when I do that, right? Yeah. Okay, so the issue. I hear the angels. The issue is the Ten of Pentacles. It's about getting your Ten of Pentacles, guys. There's nothing bad about this. This is your issue. This is the good news. Everything's gonna be great. We have a family legacy here that we're passing on. Stability. It's a prosperous time for the whole family. Empress energy here. This is birthing something into life. This is the mom energy. This is the creator energy, the you that makes something that's going to be a big successful idea from the idea. Very lucky person, very lucky energy. This Four of Pentacles, I always look at the Four of Pentacles as building your power up. And I feel like you're building the foundation to this Ten of Pentacles. I feel like that's what you're doing, is gaining control and power. And you're investing in the family. Investing in the family. Putting it all back in. Like giving it all back. All the love that you receive. Giving it back. Page of Pentacles in the past position. So there was message that came. Maybe good news. A message of a new adventure. Regarding either stability and safety and security or a new adventure in a financial realm somehow, in a financial way. The current energy, we have Knight of Cups. This could be somebody coming in for you to offer you their cup of love. Now, of course, that can be like a metaphor for a company that's going to offer you a job. Or a person that might be headed towards you. Somebody warm, compassionate, kind, maybe a little inexperienced, but this is a knight here with an offer that is genuine and sincere. This might be a child, earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn too. I forgot to say that. This is a near future energy. It's the Eight of Swords in reverse. Yay, yay. Because I feel like maybe this energy was when you were worried about your Ten of Pentacles, worried about getting this all together, having this all come together. I mean, the challenge, of course, maybe either somebody wanting to get pregnant or creating something. That might be the challenge, or the mother figure. You're feeling, I don't think you're feeling like forgiving right now. I don't feel like you're not opening your arms up and saying, come here, let me give you a hug and kiss. This is judgment in reverse. So this is not seeing things in a total non-judgmental way. It's not forgiving yet. It's not forgiving. It might be, but it's not. It's holding back. And maybe you're holding back an announcement, because this is the horseman for change. So maybe you're holding back an announcement. Maybe that's what this is about. Okay. I have the star in reverse for the external. Because so the external energy kind of has you, if this is you, it could be an Aquarius. But it's the change. It's a change of dreams, okay? It's a change of your dream, and it's a change, like the stars in the sky here, many dreams, and some don't work out. But this is going to be a change. We're needing to get hope back in the scene. We really are. We really need to get hope. Nine of Pentacles in the reverse is the hope and fear. So the fear, the hope is to have all this with the family structure. This Nine of Pentacles in reverse is trying to become independent and something just not succeeding, okay? Something just not going the way you wanted it to. But that is in the hopes and fears. That's not really an energy that's actually there. You know what I'm saying? So the outcome is Six of Cups in the reverse. Goodness. So an issue with the family, an issue with the soulmate. But we have the Three of Cups, so we're celebrating. Maybe we're fixing family issues. Yeah, okay. Look, there still are family issues. There's still like this issue, okay, that comes up. It's either with your soulmate or with the family. It's the Six of Cups. But here comes in the Page of Cups. This is a message. This is good news about something that you need to be hopeful about. Might have to do with your abundance, as we have the Three of Cups here. This can be an announcement. Maybe in the outcome, that this is where the announcement comes. There is something, and it may, you know what? Maybe it's something that like not everybody's agreeing with in the family, but it's okay. Like, it's going to be okay. This is a good thing. Like, no matter what that card is like, it's still, this is a good thing. Could be a child, Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces. Let's get another one here. Oh, complete rebirth. Ten of Swords in the reverse. It's a complete rebirth from what you've been through, and from some really hard times, from feeling like, you know, somebody stabbed you and kept on until you just didn't rise anymore. But let's get the Tiny Tarot and let's see what all's going on, clarifying things. There is a card up. I see it. There we go. All right, let's clarify things. Tiny Tarot. Four signs of Gemini. Or the lunar eclipse. What would you like to clarify? Please try and clarify the Eight of Swords in reverse for us with the near future. And kind of why this judgment is in reverse, and the star too. And the Nine of Pentacles. I'm curious about all of that. Whoop. Well, I think it's answering us. For sure. For sure, for sure. So this is about... this has to do with about being letting go of anxieties in the near future that were things that used to keep you up at night. There were things that used to keep you up at night, things that kept your mind kind of restless. Okay, Seven of Wands here. It looks like here in the past is the Seven of Wands. And I don't know why, but I'm feeling like somebody didn't get the message. Somebody didn't get a message, and therefore they weren't able to defend themselves or stand up for themselves, speak up for themselves. The star in reverse, it also is accompanied by the Five of Swords in reverse and the Eight of Swords in reverse, clarified by the Eight of Swords in reverse. The fighting, stopping. The fighting, stopping. Let's see, what else? Oh, there's conflict and arguing. This might be a really highly emotional time. I would definitely watch your temper. I would try to watch how you react. Basically, slow to react. And I think over what you're going to say before you do it. Try to be cautious. Because I see people not getting along or arguing about something. And it may have to do with, like, family. I feel like it has to do with family goals or something that benefits all, not just one. What is that about? Okay. Oh, somebody lost sight of the family in the external, okay? This doesn't have to be you. This could be somebody else. So somebody, either that a soulmate or somebody, like a situation, something like that. It's just, we couldn't celebrate anything because something just didn't go the right way. Somebody kind of separated from the good of the family or from the good of their soulmate and doesn't anticipate anything coming out of as far as this soulmate energy or family energy. All they expect to happen is for somebody to become independent. It might be yourself you're talking about, but maybe that is where the focus is at instead. Like, maybe this is great and all, but maybe the focus is also on your Nine of Pentacles, like that being a major issue. Anything else? Nine of Cups, that comes in with the offer. There's a genuine offer here, right? The outcome, too. Six of Pentacles, Two of Swords, Ten of Swords on top of the Ten of Swords in reverse. So, yeah, rebirth, celebration, hope, because there's a new offer here. Something good coming in for you. Can't make a decision. Maybe postponing things. Maybe postponing something until it's evened out. Maybe because of what happened to us in the past, we want things to be even and fair. Stop fighting over what we do first or who does what first. Okay, and then Four of Swords, a healing, perhaps some spirituality or religion in your life focused on a healing. And there's standing up for yourself and having divine on your side, happiness, joy. Happiness and joy. So just hang in there, hang tight, have some patience with the Seven of Pentacles. Everything will be fine. Everything will be fine. It looks really good. Your outcome is, you know, having a good offer come in your way. And Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, you know, we have lots of what could be children in this spread. Or it can be people meddling. But definitely a Knight of Cups. So definitely somebody coming in with a really good offer or like a company offering something to you. Okay, angel numbers. What do we have? Look, 555. So the lunar eclipse always brings in change. And we have 25. I am intelligent. You have a great ability to take in and process information on both conscious and subconscious levels. Your curiosity is endless to dive deep into a variety of subjects. You are intelligent. 31. You are disciplined. You have the organizational skills to bring your manifestations to life. And 21. You are inspiring to others. Prized conversations come from you to others. So people like what you do and they're inspired by you. Okay, this is the dream totems, Gemini. We're going to get some dream totems. What do we have? Worthwhile. Something will be worthwhile. Says life is not about being taught a lesson for getting something wrong. It's about having an experience that adds richness to your life. Preservation, reevaluate this battle you're engaged in, and a hasty retreat might be in order. Self-preservation may be the only thing salvageable. Goodness. Discretion. Friendships are fantastic when there's equality in the relationship. Maybe it's time to undertake a quick audit of your friendships to ensure that they're reciprocal. Caution, which is what they said if the horseman was here twice, that he would be meaning caution. So you really are being cautioned here. It says caution, there is no truth behind this farce. Be wary of smoke and mirrors. Okay, so something is trying to fool you. Something is trying to look like or trick you. Something might be trying to trick you or tempt you. it's all smoke and mirrors. It's an illusion. It's not real. It says, look closer and the illusion will melt away, revealing a sanctuary where only truth remains. May have to embody that strict Queen of Swords energy to do that, but I think you can't. And we have success at the bottom here, too. All right, Gemini, we're going to do some tea leaves, and I'm going to wrap your reading up. Thanks for joining me again. Okay, give assistance or get assistance, either one. The hand says, if you're in need of help or assistance and guidance, make sure you receive it, like be open to receiving it, or give it if you're able to help. Harp, great happiness. Stork, news of birth or business opportunity, maybe with that Empress energy, you know, could be an opportunity coming to life, a business coming to life, or, yeah, birth. So you have flowers, happiness, needle and thread, a sincere wish will be granted. RAT, which by the way is that acronym for like remote access to your phone, I think. So says someone working against you behind your back, or it's close enough. Something like that. Just watch out for spying. I relate it to that. So when I see it, that's what it relates to. Okay, hat. You will be playing a different role. You will be playing a different role. Okay, Gemini, maybe somebody's becoming a mama, and I feel that. So somebody's becoming a mama. Somebody might be being like a head of their own company. That might be their wish granted. It's a good reading. I thought it was a really good reading. So sending you light and love as usual. Please join me for your next reading. Bye, Gemini.